Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
There's no rain out there. Can you believe it? Awesome. It's so good to be back home and to be here with you this morning to worship together. Before we begin worship, I would just like to walk through some of the announcements. There's a few things we need to make sure you understand and know. First of all, the flowers this morning are given to the glory of God and in memory of John Streams on the 10th anniversary of his passing by his son, Bill. So the big mugs are from Bill, and it was very nice of him to do that. The Board of Deacons will gather at the church for a meeting tomorrow, Monday, October 23rd at 6:15. We will be having a congregational meeting next Sunday, October 29th, immediately following worship to approve the budget, to review the budget and approve the report of the nominating committee. And, you know, when I got up this morning, and I know it's always really dark when Ed and Jenny get up, but when I got up this morning and I went to leave the house, Dave looked out and he goes, "Whoa, it's dark." Guess what? November 5th, it's going to get darker. So remember that daylight savings time ends on the 5th, and to change your clocks. Are there any other announcements that need to be made this morning before we begin our worship? Okay, none. Okay, just a little bit of a different thing. You'll see that the video I chose is after the announcement. You know, worship is like a budget. It's a plan. And you try to make the plan work to the best of everybody's interests. So maybe it's better to do the business of the church first and then concentrate on the worship in the church. The video I chose for this morning is "To God Be the Glory," but not the "To God Be the Glory" of the hymnal. It's a more contemporary version, because if you look at the contemporary songs that we're singing in worship, they're 20 years old. They're not very contemporary. So slowly but surely, we're going to try to build some new songs into our worship memories so that we become comfortable with them. So this song was sung by a group called Sela. And Sela, if you're familiar, is a term from the Psalms. And it's like, take a break. Take a pause. And prepare your minds and hearts for worship. While you're singing, Matt and Rick and I are going to be praying up front. So Matthew, if you would start the video, try to follow along with the song. Try to sing with the song. You don't have to stand up. At the very least, concentrate on the words, okay?
To God be the glory, let me see that.
Praise the Lord, and hear His
Let's pray. Okay? Father, we thank you for this morning and for the beginning of worship. We thank you that you are with us here this morning. And we have this opportunity to glorify you, to make your presence known, to be with us as we go into our call to worship, and help us to really glorify you today, to listen to your word, and to find its meaning for us in our lives. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's go into the call to worship. And you start.
Let everyone praise God.
God does not overlook wrongdoing, but is always ready to forgive.
We give thanks for God's everlasting mercy.
Because of God's deep love for us, we are called to be covenant people.
Let us respond in faith and gratitude.
God has chosen us, and he has entrusted us to bear witness to the gospel.
We join God's labor of love to the world.
We are called to imitate Jesus and live as he lived.
Our hope is in Christ and in the power of the Holy Spirit. We serve a living God.
Let us proclaim the holiness and righteousness of God with faithfulness and joy. Again. Holy God, you are deserving of the very best we have to offer. You are deserving of the devotion of our hearts, the place of honor in our priorities, and the first fruits of our labors. We enter this time and this place and this space asking you to be in our midst to speak your message of love and mercy, to convict us and to challenge us. We welcome your spirit and open ourselves in faith and trust to your purposes and plan. Make them be yours and ours as well. Come, Creator, come, Redeemer, and Sustainer, we pray. And may our worship be acceptable in your sight. Now to a traditional song. Praise the Lord, ye heavens, adore him. Of what you find in the bulletin or what you see on the screen. It's an opportunity to receive God's mercy and share in his grace. So confident of God's love for us, let us pray together this morning's prayer of confession. Holy God, we ask for your help
your power, your spirit, so that we can amend our lives and grow more each day into the image of Christ. We confess that we fear what is different. We confess that it's easier to lock the doors of our community than to receive those who don't look like we look, worship as we worship, or think like we think. We confess that we have not lived out your call to share in abundant life and unconditional love. We believe that you have the power to turn us around to a more all-encompassing way of living. So we ask you to do that. We ask you to give us the courage to change. We ask that you give us the energy, the intelligence, and the imagination, and the love to be your people in all we say and do. Amen. When we cry out to God looking for favor in his sight, God says, "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest. In the power of the Spirit and in the name of Jesus, we are forgiven, and in his forgiveness, we will find our rest in God's mercy." Christ as we share his peace. The peace of Christ be with you all. Yeah.